was it, a death-defying auto accident, by all accounts. I should not be here tonight. And I credit God with saying to me, I was in a car accident where the cruise control stuck at 65 miles an hour going into a Caterpillar road grade. All right? True story. We hit it, and I'm standing here before you to tell you that when we hit this thing, it took off my wheel, my fender, my door, and me with it. When you hit them, they don't move. Just to let you know. Now the funny part, well, that's not the funny part yet, is that I had 9 broken ribs, 1 that punctured my lung. I had a broken pelvis in 4 spots because the seatbelt was across my lap. I put my foot on the brake, which isn't there on the passenger side, pushed my ball joint up into my hip, broke that away, had internal bleeding and a punctured lung and plastic surgery, okay? And yes, I'm suing. This is what they gave me. Alright. It's in the courts right now. But I always like to check with if anybody here with EMTs with us, because to verify the things that I talked about are very true. This happened up in Wisconsin. And I'm laying here on the side of the road, okay, pretty well banged up, and I hear the EMTs report that we have a male Caucasian who is dead. And I'm laying here thinking, this is not a good thing. And he goes, yes, we checked him out. We cannot find his insurance card. He's dead. What's gonna happen? They told me to transport the body anyways, which they did. And I heard the waitress, I'm all right. I heard the nurses reply back to them that, hey, we found his insurance card. He's alive. But his watch and his ring and wallet are gone. All right. Well, if anybody's ever worked in the medical profession and had the occasion to unfortunately go into ER, these people there are very, very cut-heavy. Doctor's brand new shirt. Doctor's brand new pair of blue jeans. And what do all parents tell their children before they leave the house? And I think, why? Well, ladies and gentlemen, 1/100 second, just before we hit, you know what I did. All right? So I said, Doc, my mother's going to call her. She has 2 questions. Is he alive and his underwear is clean? Tell him this section was, would you please? But they have code words in hospitals. You ever notice they have code words? What's the one for fast, quick, good?
Stab.
So when the doctor said to the nurse, get Mr. Brady a shot of morphine, I went, stab! Make sure that she understood what the doctor wanted, okay? And they also have other code words. Code red, fire. Code blue, someone needs to be resuscitated. Code brown, someone needed one or will need one, a bedpan. And once I got stabilized, they flew me to Little Company of Money Hospital in Evergreen Park, all right? And true story, they wanted $15,000 in advance to fly me here to Chicago. And I said to the guy, how come you want it in advance? He goes, oh, in case you don't make it. I went, oh, okay. So we go over a Little Company of Money, and if anybody's ever been there at ICU, this is a scary place when you're healthy, all right? You got pumps and all that stuff. Think about this, ladies and gentlemen. Do you know what happens there every time a baby is born at Little Company?
Yeah, they play Brahms Lullaby.
They play Brahms Lullaby throughout the whole complex. I'm in ICU. I have an epidural, that's right ladies, I had an epidural which the insurance company wasn't going to pay because I was not pregnant. I've got a morphine drip, okay, and cocaine because I had a broken nose, all right? And I'm laying there hearing, da-da-dee, I'm thinking, that's it, I'm dead, I'm at the gate, this is it, I'm gone. And we all heard stories about various hospitals, what they do, but some true ones, because I lived through it. You know the one where they say, you call the nurse, and they wake you up to give you a pill?
Yep.
Just the opposite happened. 3 o'clock in the morning, I call the nurse. I said, I can get a sleep pill. She told Mr. Brady, I can't give a sleep pill. I go, why not? She says, well, it's 3 o'clock in the morning. I go, no, it's 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm awake, I'm talking to you, I should be asleep. I want a sleeping pill. It's true as I stand here. I go, why can't I have one? She goes, you might sleep in the morning. Ma'am, I've checked my schedule. I'm not doing a darn thing tomorrow. I thought I'd sleep in, all right? And I figured out what it is. They want you up, wake. They want you done at 6 to be bathed, clean, washed, all the pills taken, all the blood tests taken, go out fit, done by 9 o'clock. It's Oprah's on. That's what it is. And lastly, they had a time over there, the doctor, I had a tube in my lung. Okay, about 1/2 inch tube, 4 inch tube in my lung, collapsed lung. And the doctor said, Mr. Brady, we're going to take this tube out of your lung. I says, okay, doc. He goes, well, no matter what happens, we want you to continue on breathing. Well, if there's a chance, Doc. Why are we doing this? He goes, well, no matter what, just keep on bringing. He says, and just keep on doing this. Don't worry, don't be nervous. I've done hundreds of these. I said, this is my first, and I'm a little scared. Well, Dr. Rambo put his foot at the edge of my bed, and they wrapped this thing around his hand, and they yanked it out. I'm going, he's going, breathe. I get a nickel bandage and a bill for $400. I could have tied it to the door. Someone ripped it out there when they walked in the door. They're crazy over there. Hospitals are crazy, crazy things over there. Speaking about crazy, I don't know why that segue came in at this point in time using that word crazy. I need to have Father Jay come up here right now. Father Jay, look out, Jay, that's right. Boss. Father Jay, our pastor. Give me a hand up. Yes, we have a, where are the raffle ladies? We have the baskets of apples. See now, in show business, well, this is a kill time. So if you soft shoe, you know any jokes?
Soft shoe.